Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So I know I've been neglecting my car content recently just because I moved into this new house, but I just haven't had time to do much car content. So I've been doing DIY house stuff lately. What we're gonna do today is I'm gonna add some extra power outlets to the house and also add an Ethernet port to my home office here. So stay tuned. So this new house basically comes with everything I wanted except real structured wiring. So if you guys don't know what structured wiring is basically having like cable outlets, phone outlets, and TV outlets in every room, which all home runs back to one panel where you can make all the connections and distribute your information or your data or whatever throughout the house. So this house was built in 2017, and I thought in 2017 they would have structured wired the whole house, but apparently with wireless and everything now, a lot of these builders are kind of cutting back and not putting those things into the house. This house has somewhat of a structured wiring. They added all the wiring to like the living room, the master bedroom, and a few other rooms, and they have all the security camera wiring throughout the house. But in a room like this, which is the home office, the den area, they didn't put any data ports. What I wanted to do was put an Ethernet port so I can actually have my gigabit network throughout the house, and I can actually write to my network drive and everything at gigabit speed. You know, with wireless, you get pretty fast these days with the AC stuff, but there is latency and doesn't perform as advertised all the time, as I already tested. I've got an AC like 2600 network in my house right now for the wireless stuff, and it still doesn't hit the speeds that I want. So in this room, I just want to run a Cat5 drop in here and home run it back to my box, so that way I can connect it to all my other network devices there through a switch. Apologize for this big old mess in here, but I'm moving into this house and I've just got stuff everywhere, unpacking all my old stuff. So over here is where my day job setup is. So I've got that over here. On this side, I've got my home setup, which is where I do my video editing and other personal stuff on this side. So what I want to do is put a Ethernet port on this wall right here, and then from there I want to run it to a router or a switch that's going to be in this room, one of my nodes. So in a single story house, this is a pretty easy job. All you do is just go up above the ceiling, drop a wire straight down, and then cut a hole and pull it out over here. Except I'm in a two-story house, so my problem is I can't get above the ceiling. So the only other way you can do that in a house like this is to find the nearest Cat5 run or some way to get a Cat5 run in here. And luckily, this is an outside wall, and I'll show you in a second what I found on the other side. In addition to the Cat5 drop that I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna put a power outlet right under this desk right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut a hole over here. There's actually a outlet on the back side of this that I'm gonna tap into because it shares the same wall. So we're outside the house now, and I'll show you exactly what I found on the outside. So this is the window for my home office right here, and we're like at the corner of the house. I was messing around out here and I realized, oh crap, I've got some data drops right here on the back wall, except I've got concrete block right here, so I gotta drill through this concrete block. So the initial thing I discovered is I've got a cable wire right here, and then I've got a data cable right here that goes into the DSL phone box. And that one, since we don't have home phone or DSL in this house, I really don't need that line. So that was my initial thought, was to use this line, disconnect it and cut it in here and just use that Cat5. So I got curious and I opened this box to see what was in here, and I hit the jackpot in here also. Looks like the house came with one cable drop and one data drop for the cable side, and then it came with another drop here. So in here, looks like what I got is just a solid cable. I'm not sure what this cable is, but this one for sure is a Cat5 cable because it matches this guy right here. This thing is actually home run back to the box. So what I'm gonna do today is go into here. I'm gonna drill a hole through here. Hopefully I don't damage anything. And I'm gonna fish a line through to the other side, and I'm gonna make the connection to this guy. So after studying this a little bit more, there is a little bit of room right next to this where I can actually work with it, but the box is in the way. So first thing I'm gonna do is unscrew this box to kind of get it out of the way. It looks like I was wrong about this being a cable line. So this looks like some kind of data, but it's not telephone data. because telephone data is up here from CenturyLink. Just to double check, I opened up the CenturyLink box and it looks like, so this is that wire that's going in here and terminating right here onto the CenturyLink, which is this side, which looks correct for the phone that's going into the structured wiring box, and it actually shows the home run to this. So this is a structured home run box for the stuff that's coming in from the outside, like the cable and the phone. And this line right here, which used to say HR, I had marked it with DSL outside, is the one that has service in. So I'm assuming that's the one that goes in a CenturyLink right now. And then there was one wire that was unaccounted for up here. I actually added this switch after I moved in to connect everything together, but there was one that I labeled outside. I believe it was this guy. So we'll go ahead and check the security box and see what wires we find in there. So right now I'm in the security alarm box, and it looks like the alarm has that one orange wire right here that goes into it. Then it has a blue wire, but it's not the same blue wire that we found out there. We have this wire. This goes back to that box upstairs in my switch because I'm using it as a backhaul for my mesh network back here. So I've got my long drill bit here for cinder block. Stick it through this hole that they have. This house has a 8-inch cinder block or concrete block construction. It's also got a layer of stucco on here. So I'm assuming this is gonna be like 8 or 9 inches. That is 9 inches. So there's about an inch of stucco on this wall. Before I even go in there, I'm gonna actually scope this inside this hole. So I've got this scope camera that I bought on Amazon. Connects up to any PC or Android phone. So I'm gonna connect it up and see what's inside of here. It also has a light on it. So we'll go see what's inside this block before we start drilling. So I've got it connected right here on this camera. The light is already activated. So I'm way inside right now, and there's actually already a hole that goes into the drywall. I can always just find that hole and then just penetrate it. So right now I'm in here. So that's the blue Cat 5. That's that other phone line. That's my drill bit right here in the middle. And it's actually touching right through that penetration of the cinder block and onto the, I believe it's the insulation before the drywall. So what I'm gonna do is get a hammer and try to tap this through and see if I can maybe make an indentation on the backside and know where I am in the building. So I found the indentation is right here. We'll basically have to cut right here to line up with that guy, and we should be able to reach up, get to this little bump right here where the wire is going up, and I can intercept it right there. I'm gonna end up putting this low voltage old work over here right below where we came in on that wire right here. So what I need to do is basically I measured this outlet over here and it's 11 inches off the ground. So I'm gonna start at 11 inches and then I'm gonna draw a square or a rectangle right here and end up getting this slot right there. I made my little template right here. So this thing is basically 3¾ inch tall and then 2¼ inch wide. So I just made a template out of a piece of paper. And I'll just trace it onto here. And then that way I know where to cut. So we'll get the scope up in here. So you got the hole, the wire coming through that. So I found this piece of plenum rated patch cable with the termination ends on it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go outside, I'm gonna put my little clothes hanger, get this through that little hole enough so when I reach in here, I can just pull it down. I'm gonna leave the termination ends on each side. That way I can have connectors or I can make butt connections using an adapter on the outside. So I got that thing pushed through the cinder block. Now I'm gonna scope it. Freaking scope is badass. I mean, this thing's really helped me see everything in there. If you guys don't have one of these for your Windows or Android device, unfortunately it doesn't work for Apple, but yeah, this thing makes really quick work of looking at stuff and doing everything. The only thing I don't like about the app I'm using for it is that the app keeps on timing out because it doesn't keep the window open, but other than that, it is pretty slick and it works really well. I'll have a link down in the description on Amazon where I got this. It was like 30 bucks, but it's more than paid for itself already from just doing this right now. So the next thing I'm gonna do is terminate this cable coming in. I bought this 2-pack of data ports, which is the push down type and the faceplate off of Amazon. And if you guys need this and you don't want to go pick it up at your local Home Depot, you get these on Amazon. I think these were only like, I think the set was like $5 or $6, but I got the cover plate with two ports and then I got two push downs. And you gotta be careful when you order these that if you get the push down or do you get the pass through for the cable. I wanted the push down because I knew I was gonna terminate these. They've got the wiring layout on each side, which color wires you wanna use. If you're doing this for data, you wanna use the B wiring. So anytime you do data, A is more common for voice, B is common for data, so you wanna use the B. I use my Cat5 termination tool, so it comes with that little thing that helps you push it in and makes good contact, and it's got this other crimper to terminate the Cat5 plugs, which I have a bunch of right here to make cables with. Then I also have the tester, so anytime you terminate anything, you wanna put a patch cable on there and test it also. So we'll go ahead and just cut this thing in half, and the cutting portion of the crimper. It has a little thing for the stripper, so you put the wire in there and you just strip back the insulation. So I've got my tester right here. I'm actually just testing the patch cable I have. I use the number 2, the S setting. It slowly goes through each one and verifies that it's communicating. This cable is fully tested and it works. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna unplug this, and this is the remote. I'm gonna go outside and plug it into one of the ports out there. Then I'm gonna plug it into here where I just terminated. I'm gonna check, make sure everything passes through. So you would just plug this in. I'll leave this guy inside and I'll go outside and plug this. So it looks like everything's blinking. So that's a good sign. So to make the final terminations, I just wanna trim these little edges off on here so I can put the cap on. All right, so we've lost sunlight and we're out here in the dark with the light to work. As I was saying earlier, how I terminated with the B on the inside. Luckily, I was correct because the cable is set up as a Cat5B, but the rest of the house that I noticed is wired Cat5A, which doesn't matter when you're just passing through like a patch cable. So this is acting like a patch cable right now. So we need to basically cut the rest of these and terminate them with RJ45 plug-in connectors. All right, so after fumbling around with this, I got it all to line up and get in the hole. And I also got it where the insulation is gonna get crimped, plus it's all the way through to the end, pressed nice and firmly through. I'll show you guys a graphic of what this A is supposed to look like, but yeah, it's a pain trying to get those all lined up. I've got this thing all set up. What you do is thing right through and then squeeze it and it's gonna crimp it. Just make sure all the cables are in, that you can see all of them through the end here and from the sides. So they're all slid in and the insulation is past the little nub here and then you can crimp it. All right, so I got this all terminated. I used that little jumper block right there to jumper that cable. And then up here, I made the two connections. I clipped that DSL wire, made the two connections. And then I'm gonna route this wire up through this hole, through this little nipple right here, into here. And then I'm gonna plug that up and test everything out and see how everything works. So everything tested out fine. So both ports jump all the way back to the home run. I tested both of them. It works with all the cables I tested, so I'm good with this. So I'm gonna move on to the electrical outlet now. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add that outlet under here like I explained earlier. Instead of cutting it with a regular drywall saw, I actually found this oscillating tool with a box cutter over at Harbor Freight. That box cutter was only like $13 or $14 and it cuts a perfect box in seconds. And I just bought this oscillating tool for like $50 on Amazon. So we'll go ahead and cut that right now and I'll show you before we even start what to do, especially if you're trying to get an outlet on the other side of a wall that already has an outlet. The easiest way is to open the other side, try to punch a hole through to kind of figure out where the outlet goes back to back. And then basically just punch a hole kind of offset from that so you can actually run your short wire across through and then you can make that connection pretty easily. So we're over here in the dining room area, which is on the back side of my den. Here's the outlet that we're gonna tap the power from. So first thing you wanna do is make sure your breaker is off for this thing and then take it out, pull the outlet out and then try to punch a hole through with like a clothes hanger or something that can penetrate the drywall. And what you don't want to do is just have this back to back, because it'll actually hit it. Most likely the beam is on either side of this. So if it's on this side, then we'll basically offset the back box on this side, so that way we could run the wire across. Well, if you look inside the box, you can see that little tab that I pushed away. All you have to do is take a little clothes hanger, puncture a hole through to kind of figure out where you're at on the other side. So to figure out which side the beam is on, you kind of got to look inside here and actually see it. I see the nail going this way, so the beam is actually on this side. So when I get to the other side, I got to offset the box on this side right here. So we're on the back side and you can see where that hole I punctured through. So I'll just get some touch-up paint on there to fix that. So that other side is right about there. So actually my outlet will be on this side. So I gotta move my desk a little bit. So what we wanna do next, measure everything out, get your lines in. Ooh yeah, that was simple, 2 seconds. Dusty as hell though. All right, so I fished that piece out. Here's what it looks like. Then what we're gonna do first is just test fit our box. Make sure that fits in there good, so all the wings and everything look like it's good for the old work box. First thing I wanna do is fish the wire through. Once I fish the wire through and I can reach it, then I'll put it through one of these little tabs here. Then I'll screw it tight, wire it all up. Go in here, pull your wire through. Right there. Make sure you have enough slack. Now we got the wings all nice and tight. We just want to go ahead and terminate this and put the cover on. Once we bolt it all down, make sure everything's nice and tight. Just get your wall plate, put it on, and we are good to go. Just tighten it up. Also, for all of you guys that do this, make sure you put the screw in vertically. Nothing says amateur work like a screw that's not turned straight. All right, now we're gonna test, make sure this baby works, that has power. I just unplugged my UPS. Plugged it in and everything works. So now I have an outlet right below my desk. Anyways, if you guys found this video useful for your home improvement and any other projects you're doing, give it a thumbs up. I know this is not my usual car content, but I got a new house and this is the third new house I've had in my life. So I like to do these little projects to get everything the way I like it. Thanks for watching and don't forget to tune in next time. Hopefully I'll get some car content on the channel, but in the meantime, I'm just doing all these little house projects around the house. If you guys need any of these tools or this equipment that I use, I'll leave a link down in the description for all the stuff I use. Most of it I bought on Amazon, but a few of the stuff you could pick up at Harbor Freight or your local tool stores.